The Storm Crown Part 1. The family went to see an old castle. Most of it had fallen down a long time ago. It is just a ruin, said Chip. Kiba wanted to climb on a wall, but Dad said no. We must look after old ruins, he said. Once upon a time, it was a big castle, said Biff. I wonder what it was like to live here. Mom found a good spot for a picnic. Fluffy saw a rabbit hole. He began to dig in the ground. Chip saw something shining in the dirt, so he picked it up. It is a glass bead, he said. I wonder who lost it, said Biff. Chip looked at the bead through his magnifying glass. Then he put it in his pocket. I don't think it is valuable, he said. Later, Chip came into Biff's room. He had a book about castles. Suddenly, the magic began to glow. The magic took Biff and Chip back in time. It took them to the castle. Some people were waiting outside a big door. An important man came up. I'm Lord Kent, said the man. Here is your present for the prince. Biff and Chip didn't have a present. Think of something, Chip, said Biff. We have a magic glass, said Chip. It makes small things too big. Look big. That is a good present, said Lord Kent. The prince will like it. Put it on this cushion. Then wait outside in the line. At last, Biff and Chip went into a hall. That was quick thinking. Chip said, Biff, I wonder who this prince is. He must be important, said Chip. The prince was sitting on a throne. Chip gave him a magnifying glass. I love it, said the prince. The prince jumped off the throne and looked through the magnifying glass. Tomorrow it is an important day, he said. Tomorrow I will be the king. You can call me Henry, but tomorrow I will be King Henry, he said. Come with me. He ran out of the hall. Harry ran up some stairs. Come and see my crown, he said. I want to look at the throw at it. Throw. Through this magic glass, two guardians looked at Biff and Chip. We are here to see that the crown is not stolen, said a soldier. Hold your arms up. We must search you. Harry took Biff and Chip into a small room in a tower. Biff and Chip gasped when they saw the crown. It looks very valuable, said Chip. If it was stolen, I could not become king, said Harry. become king, said Henry, but it's safe in this tower. Nobody could take it from here. Henry took Biff and Chip to see his horse. I shall ride him when I become king tomorrow, he said. Suddenly they heard shouting, Lord Kent, run up to Henry. Come quickly, he shouted, your crown has been stolen. Henry ran back up the stairs to the crown room. The guards were still outside the door. The crown is missing, said a guard. How can it be missing? Asked Henry. We don't know, said a guard. Nobody has been here except you. Except you. I know who stole it, said Lord Kent. These children have stolen it, Lord Kent went on. They use magic to do it. Throw them in prison at once. Oh, said Biff, now we are in trouble. Now race part two.